Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. In today's video, we are going to learn about instantaneous center, or you can, in short, you can say IC. So what is an IC? IC is the center of two or more links working together. Okay. So if you are having a system in which there is more than one link present, so those are going to have a common center. Okay, so in this case, we are having double wishbone suspension in which there is one upper arm and one lower arm. Okay, so if you extend these lines, okay, so they will meet or they will go parallel. Okay, they will go in non-parallel direction. Okay, so somewhere at this location, if you extend these arms, okay, there will be a common center where they will intersect. Okay, so that is the IC, that is the instantaneous center. Okay, and if you connect that point from the tire contact patch, which is this, so that is the swing arm, that you can call it as a swing arm. Okay, so there are two types of IC. One is front view, okay, you can say front view swing arm, okay, front view IC, and one more is there which is called as side view IC. So if you extend the lines of the mount position where the arms, both the arms are pivoted, okay, so you will get a common center where, so wherever those lines will meet, okay, there you are going to have that instantaneous center. Okay, so let's dive into the designing. Okay, how you can evaluate or generate the IC. Okay, so for that, I'm assuming you are already having a suspension geometry like this. So this is nothing, just a box. These are the pivoting or mounting points. This is the knuckle arrangement. And these are just the wheel, the tire layout, which I have made here. Okay, so this is the front right. This is front right. Okay, position. So let's make, so for that I'm using 3D sketching. So go to the center line. I just need a construction line. Okay, so from the center of the upper ball joint, you make a line anywhere, okay, and leave it like that. Okay, now for better understanding, I will just hide some sketches, so tire also we don't need. Okay, so now you connect the line, this imaginary line of the upper arm. Okay, so there we will connect to the midpoint of this line. Okay, so what is this line? Okay, this line is the line which connects the front mounting and the rear mounting of the upper arm. Okay, so the center of that line, okay, should pass from that line. Okay, so that is the line which we just made. Okay, similarly do for the lower arm. So again go to the center line, construction line, click on the upper ball joint, lower ball joint, and again the line which connects the front and the rear mount of the body side of the lower arm, the midpoint of that line you connect with the line. Okay, so there how you will see, so you can click on the line which you just clicked and this line, and you can click on the coincident button. Okay, so now you see you extend these lines such that they crisscross each other. So at location and at this location, they are crossing each other. So there will be a point. Okay, but see, when you rotate the screen, they are not cutting each other. Okay, so in front view, it seems that they will cut here somewhere. Okay, so what we can do, we can make a line and, okay, we can make a line which will be along the z-axis. Okay, this is not along the z-axis, it is slightly angle this line is at slight angle. So what you do when you have connected the line, okay, it will pass through, it will move along these two lines, okay? So if you give this line along z-axis, you click on this button here, it will become defined, fully defined it will become. See, the color has changed, it has become black, okay? So now this line, the midpoint of this line will be the IC, okay? Once again, what we did, first we made a line which is passing from the center of the pivoting line, okay? So this is the pivoting axis, okay? So this line we made which is passing from the middle point of the pivoting axis, okay? Then we did the same for the lower arm as well. This line is passing from the middle point of the pivoting axis of the lower arm, okay? So, and we extended the line. And then what we are doing, we made a line which will touch both the lines but will be along the z-axis, okay? So this midpoint of this line is going to be your IC. Okay, you can note down the coordinates. Okay, coordinates are coming here. Okay, and for making the swing arm, you can join it like this. So this is important, like if you are connecting your middle point of the generated line to the tire contact patch, that is going to be the swing arm, okay? So I will select the line and make it solid. So this is the swing arm for this suspension configuration, okay? So we always try to keep this IC, this instant in its center, as closer to the ground, okay? Because if it is having more height with respect to ground, then during cornering condition or bump condition, you will have significant amount of suspension travel. That you can always control with the shock absorber, okay? But the natural tendency will be of the suspension will be very much bumpy, or you can say a lot of bounce and jounce will be there, okay? So try to keep it as much as lower or as closer to the ground. That can be done by reducing the ground clearance, or you can change the angle. So this is the angle of the A-arms where you, like the angle at which you are installing or positioning the A-arms, okay? You can also increase the track width, okay, if it allows you. So in that way, you can lower or control the position of the insert in a center, okay? So that is how you do that. That is how we can find out the IC, front IC, okay? So yeah, that's it for the video. Thank you for watching.